Help, I have done it again. I have been here many times before.
This is really about the issue of women's health.
We're protecting women's health and safety.
We are protecting women's health.
I just wanted to reiterate that this is really all about protecting the health and safety of women.
Oh, hurt myself again today.
And by the turn of the century, both birth control and abortion were illegal in most states. If a woman needed medical treatment after a botched abortion, even though infected and bleeding, she was often required to testify against her husband or lover and the abortionist before she could receive medical care.
I, Maria Hecht, believing I am about to die, make this my antemortem statement.
I, Cora Alice Grimes, about to die, make this statement. On the second day of July, 1896, James Dunn, a retail merchant, gave me a packet of Calomel.
I, Renetti Parker, am about to die.
I was rushed to the emergency room with a fever of 105 and blood poisoning. I had had an illegal abortion.
13 years old, and she is a victim of rape, and she drove 4 hours from McAllen to San Antonio, and we had to turn her away.
I had to be rushed to emergency. And I just remember this excruciating pain.
Blindfolded, without anesthetic, I never saw the face of the abortionist.
And the worst part is there's no one else.
Our decision for us to choose.